the question?
How long ago was it that you did it? How long have you been in the prison? Probably 4 months far. How far did you go to school, college, AA business administration? And what college did you attend at National College, Florida National University? Did you read and write in English?
Yes, sir.
Are you presently under the influence of any narcotics, medication, or alcohol beverage?
Oh, sir.
Are you being treated for or suffering from any mental problems? Do you recognize this form I present to you now as being the same form that you wore earlier today?
Yes, sir.
For the record, I'm joined by the defendant, a Miami-Dade Police Department grand jury form. At this point, I'm going to ask you if you can read the form for me.
Do you have the right to read that? You do not have to talk to me. Wish to do so. Do you not have to answer my questions? Do you understand that right? Yes.
She started ranting.
you know, why we didn't, I didn't wake up at 1:30 after we went out last night to my yacht club, and I mentioned to her that my stepdaughter was passed out by 10:30 at night. So
she was upset about the plan that she had for you to wake her up at 1:30?
Yes, yes. And, correct. And then she started throwing stuff, objects towards me as a weapon. And then I pulled out my weapon. And then I told her, hey, back off, or I'm going to call the cops. And she goes, oh, I called the cops with Harry, and I didn't do anything. Oh, sorry. I didn't do anything in Cuba.
You say that she was throwing things at you. Mm-hmm. What exactly was it that she was throwing?
Towels, mascara, creams, anything she can grab her hand. Boxes, anything in the room she could throw at me. I was just ducking. I got hit in the face a few times.
Did you sustain any injuries at that point?
No. Only when she was pushing and punching me afterwards, when I got upset. That's when I went back and grabbed her.
You stated that during this initial argument in your room, before she was throwing it out, that you armed yourself with your firearm?
Yes, but I armed myself, which I forgot to leave that part out. I armed myself when she started pushing and then and punching. Then I backed up and I went and got the gun.
And where did you obtain the firearm from?
In the closet of my pants, on my holster.
So at the time you brought the firearm out, was it in a holster?
Correct. I pulled it out on the holster.
And what did you do at that point?
Safety was on, and I pointed towards her, I told her to stop, and then I let her, and she let her know to take these on.
Sorry.
Yes,
sir. Can you read that
in, sir? The safety was on, I put it, and took it to her, like, and pointed it towards her, and then she basically said, you know, well, I told her that the safety was on, but she was like, you know, oh, you're not going to kill me, you're not going to do anything, whatever. No, I'm not. There's no need for that, but you just stop punching me.
Down.
Okay.
And she said, you're not
going to
kill me, what?
Well, she said that you're not going to kill me, and I said, no, of course not. The safety is on that. That wasn't my motive. Then once you stop punching me and attacking me.
At that point, did she enter the room?
Yes, she left. I went into my, I put the gun back. She was still there. I went back, I put the gun back into the spot in the holster in the pants, in the closet. I went into bed and she was in the bathroom. And then she was throwing stuff and still trying to agitate me, push me on the wire. And I was like, and then she said that she was going to leave me tonight and pack her stuff. I said, that's fine. She, okay, sorry. Yeah. Then she said she was going to leave me at midnight when I go to work. So I worked midnight and she got like 2 weeks vacation off. And I said, go right ahead.
And at that point, did she leave the room?
Correct, but she left a couple times back and forth to throw stuff and keep on trying to agitate.
Did there come a point where she was downstairs?
Yeah.
At that point, did you exit your room and go downstairs?
When she exited the apartment, yes. She had to find out what was going on.
And when you went downstairs, were you armed with your firearm at that point?
No.
When you went downstairs and spoke with your wife, where did that discussion take place then?
In the kitchen.
And at that point, did she have a weapon in her hand at that time?
No.
At some point during your argument downstairs, did there come a point where you returned to your room on the job?
Or she punched me several times.
Yeah, let me finish.
Yes, sorry, sir.
Did there come a point where you went upstairs and obtained your firearm again for a second time?
Yes, after I was
rewatched. And at that time when you armed yourself with your firearm, what did you do?
I went downstairs, you know, confronted her, saw what she was doing, and she had a knife in her hand. I grabbed the knife in my right hand, put it back in the drawer, and then she kept on punching me like crazy again, then I fired.
Take you back for 1 second. When you were coming downstairs, where was she?
In the kitchen.
And did you have the firearm in your hand?
Yes, I did.
And when you came downstairs and saw her in the kitchen, did
she have the knife at that point? And she looked at it towards me, and she was like, had it towards you, which was going to be so good. Did she say anything to you about it? Yeah, you know, you're not going to kill me, blah, blah, blah. Just like, you're a pussy, and all that stuff. Now, you stated that she had a knife in her hand. Can you describe the knife? Silver, about a foot long, with a black handle. And did she make a direct threat to you with that knife?
Mm-hmm.
What did she say to you?
Well, she said that you're not going to kill me at first, and then she said, I'm going to kill you, you know, because you were pulling out a gun.
And you stated that you disarmed her?
Correct.
Was your firearm in your hand at the time that you disarmed her?
Correct.
And what did you do with the knife once you took it out of her hand?
Put it in the drawer.
And at that point, did you close the drawer?
Yeah.
Was she armed with any other weapon at this time?
No.
Just a box cutter. What happened next?
She just started firing punches like crazy over the top. And she was really, like really attacking. Like I was getting out of the way, I got hit in the arm, and she was like going for my temple. I felt like she was, you know, she was trying to just take me out. And then also, she did make threats upstairs about me dying, and she hopes I die, and then she'll get someone to kill me, whatever it is. She did make those threats upstairs.
So after she hit you in the kitchen,
I fired.
I fired
away. I shot her.
How many times did you discharge your weapon?
I want to say 6 to 8 times.
Was that full capacity of your gun that night?
Full capacity, like
your firearm was fully loaded,
correct?
Magazine capped out. And what did you do with the gun after you shot?
Well, she was still lunging and throwing punches even when I did shoot her. She was still fighting. I put it upstairs in the closet again, on top of the pants, and then I got some pants and jeans. I talked to my stepdaughter, told her to keep this door closed, don't come downstairs. I told her to stay there, and then I went downstairs. Took the picture, and then I just locked the door.
Now let me ask you, back to the fight when you were in the kitchen with her. When she was hitting you, was she near the hallway, or was she...
No, it was all in the kitchen.
Let me finish the question. When she was hitting you, were you closer to the hallway?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and is that closer to the exit of the residence? Like the front door to the residence?
That's what you mean? It's kind of like in the back, you know, the front. It's kind of like in the middle, yeah.
But your kitchen is a U-shaped kitchen.
Yeah.
And you were near the hallway.
That's right. Yes.
So you are closer to the hallway, which leads to the...
Correct.
Front door of the house. Now, you stated that you took a picture. What did you take a picture of?
Of her.
Was she deceased at that point?
Yes.
And why did you take a photo?
So the family would know and be notified, and they can rush over there and get my stuff on.
And what did you do once you took that photo?
Uploaded it on Facebook, on her page, so the family could see.
And when you uploaded it on her page, did you upload it on your Facebook page as well?
Because I have her family and friends.
And at any point prior to leaving the house, did you call 911?
You don't just say that loud.
No, I didn't. Sorry.
Once you exited the residence, did you lock the door behind you?
Yes, I did. Bottom lock.
What did you do after that?
I went straight to my aunt's house.
Straight to you?
My aunt's house.
And your aunt's name is?
Valerie Medina.
And do you know her address?
6841 Southwest 48th Street, Miami, Florida, 33155.
And once you were at your aunt's house, what did you do?
I pretty much informed them that I just killed my wife, that she was abusing me, and she said why. She was crying, she was a little confused, and then
Nash Abby. The full name is Abby Chapman.
Can you spell that?
Well, it's going to be hard to talk about. A-B-I-U-C-H-A-N-I. And you then informed Nash as well as your dad that you had shot him with?
Yes, I did.
And who took you to the organization?
My dad, Derek Medina. Derek Ian Medina.
And did you go to the police station voluntarily?
Yes.
And once you got, what police station did you go to?
City of South Miami.
And when you got there, what did you do?
I informed the dispatcher that I just killed my wife and she was attacking me. And then she said, okay, wait here. And then police, City of South Miami came over, they checked if I had weapons, and then they took me to the cell.
I'm going to take you back for a moment. When you shot your wife, where did you shoot your wife at?
I believe it was in the stomach and up. It could have gone up to her chest area, to the throat, to the neck. From the neck to the stomach.
And do you know how many times you actually hit your wife?
Everything that was in there, here. Everything that was in the full round.
So every round that you fired, you hit your wife?
Correct.
Take you back now to your prior, jobs. Was there ever a point in time where you were an amateur boxer?
Yeah.
And how long were you an amateur boxer?
Since 2004. 2007, I started professional.
And what was your record as an amateur boxer?
Wait a second, I'm finished.
Sorry.
What
was your record as an amateur boxer?
25 now.
And that means that you never lost a fight?
Correct.
Are you right-handed or left-handed?
Right-handed.
Shot your wife, did she say anything?
No, she just kept on trying to attack me. She was in shock, she had an expression. Like, she was shocked, but she still was trying to swing at me, trying to nudge at me.
What type of expression did she have to describe?
She was, her mouth open up in shock. A gasp of shock.
Did she ever ask for help when she was falling to the ground?
No.
Chest. who saw it online, dealt with this for 4 years, and never had a Holocaust. We've been able to resolve it, and you know it's going to get to this.
So during the course of your wife being abusive to you over 4 years, at no point did you ever call police?
No, I just informed my family.
Did you ever think that maybe involving the police could help your situation?
Nope.
And you chose not to call the police today because why?
I wanted to turn myself out. I wanted to go in voluntarily. I didn't want a call. And I didn't want my stepdaughter to see all that.
Now, you stated earlier that you feel things could have gone differently.
Mm-hmm.
How do you think things could have turned out differently?
If it didn't even start from the beginning. If the fight didn't, the verbal fight didn't start from the beginning. Like, you just could have been handled differently. Eric, talked about not fighting in front of my stepdaughter. So my wife knows that I'm not going to fight, with my stepdaughter today, even before that, but I try not to even get into it, just ignore it. That's why I was trying to go back to sleep, because I don't know how my stepdaughter evolved. So she was pushing me and attacking me from upstairs to downstairs.
Now, you stated earlier that your family was aware of the abuse that your wife was inflicting upon you. Did you ever photograph any of those injuries?
Yes, I did.
Where are those photographs?
On the phone at my handbook.
And what are those photographs of?
Just my arm. I didn't get my chest because I had my tank up on.
Is that from today?
Mm-hmm.
So the photographs that are on your phone reflect the injury that was sustained today?
And video.
Prior to today, did you ever show anybody any injuries that you sustained from your wife?
Mm-hmm.
What was that?
Oh, yeah, my family, when I got there, they saw it, my hands.
You're talking about today's injury?
Yes,
I showed it. Prior to today?
No.
Has anybody seen any injuries that you sustained as a result of your wife prior to today?
No, because it just happened in the morning, so it's impossible. It happened 10-something in the morning.
And why didn't you leave the house and move?
Because my wife is suicidal and she's attempted suicide before, and if I leave the house, she will overdose on medication.
Had any of those prior suicide attempts? Have you ever called 911 to report any of those prior suicide attempts?
No, sir.
And when you shot her, were you in fear for your life?
Yes.
And why?
She was repeatedly punching me and trying to get to my temple, my neck. When I say I was in fear, there was a shot with her punch towards my chest area because she was getting close to my neck. So I was in fear with my neck, her catching me into the throat and to the temple on the left side. But the arm wasn't, she's not going to kill me punching my arm.
How you left her?
decided to take care of his old people, you will see me in the news, my wife was punching me. And I'm not going to stand anymore with this abuse. I did what I did. I hope you understand.
And did you write that statement?
Yes, sir.
And did you post that statement online?
Yes, sir. It's right over here.
All right, I want to give you a pen. If you could just print your name and sign your name at the bottom.
Talking at the same time.